Hey guys, for today's video, I have the new Fenty Beauty Diamond Balm 2 All Over Diamond Veil. So before I start, I did last year do a video on the first one that came out. I'll link that down below if you're interested. For today's video, I'll focus on the second one, but compare it a little bit to the first one just in case you want to see that. So this shade is called Hollow At Me. They describe it as a pure pink iridescent sparkle. It's limited edition and it's 50 Canadian or 38 US dollars, and you get 8 grams or 0.28 ounces of product, which is all the same as the first one. Overall, I would say these two products are very similar, just the sparkles inside are different colors. The packaging looks pretty, but it feels just kind of plasticky and like cheapish. Actually today when I was playing with this is the first time it's happened, but this bottom plate now just kind of comes off for me whenever I try to open it, so that is awesome. The top panel seems to be a little bit more secure than the bottom one, but like rude. I really love the shape that the product's in, like in the pan. It looks beautiful, except when things are shaped all nice like that, it just makes me not want to use it because I don't want to wreck it. Because it's just so perfect. First world problems, am I right? So the product looks like it has this white base, but you don't see that at all when you apply it. It looks like it might be kind of a dusty looking highlighter, but the white base doesn't come through at all. It's actually, it applies as just clear with glitter. When you put your finger on it, it doesn't feel as soft and buttery and gel-like as the first one does. When you put your finger on the first one, it just feels so soft. And this one's a little bit like harder and it just feels a bit more stiff and dry, which hasn't proven to be a bad thing. I love this shade. It's the pink sparkles are really flattering pink color. They're not like a hot pink. They're a nice peachy pink, kind of like a warm toned version of the first one. I'll show you the swatches of the two so you can see they are just very similar, just different glitter colors. I would say in the first one, the glitter chunks are just a little bit more defined and chunky. They're not chunky though, but they are more so than this one. This one, I think the glitter is very, very fine. I think they're just smaller than the first one. And I would say the first one has a more wet look when it's on your skin, and this one just looks more glittery. I mean, they're both glittery, but the first one just kind of looks a bit more wet, and that's the only way I can think of how to describe it. I would say between the two of them, I like the second one better just because of the color and tone of the glitter. Well, okay. I like the look of the first one better. I think it's more appealing, but for me, I prefer to have more pinks and warmer tones on my face than the cold silver tones, you know? So I'll show you how I like to apply this. I like using this brush from Tarte. I use it for pretty much all of my highlighters. It's just a fluffy highlighting brush. Put that and I just go for it in the pan. I like dig it right in there. Because it is a fluffy brush and it's just glitters that you're picking up, you really gotta like pack it on if you're using the brush. So I go in with that first, and then if I want more places to have a little bit more glitter, I'll use my finger and just kind of pat it where I want it. And I think it actually, I don't know, it's not a tacky looking glitter, I think. It looks pretty nice. The only thing is I'm having a hard time getting it to like really show up nicely on camera. So bear with me if you think, wow, that looks not that nice. It looks really good in person, just please believe me. Or just go to Sephora and try it out for yourself. It looks awesome on its own, but if you really want to get like a nice glow, I think put on your favorite highlighter and then this over top on like the highest points. I think that would look beautiful. Overall, I'm a big fan. I'm just not a big fan of the cheap packaging. I wish for 50 bucks it was a little bit more luxurious. I don't know. I think it would look really nice on everyone's skin tone. I was a little bit worried that I might be too pale for it because it's just like pink, but it actually looks nice. Yeah, that's all I have for today's video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you later. Bye.